Hello, my name is Samantha Whelan-Kokas. Welcome to my home in beautiful Calgary, Alberta, Canada. I am a teaching artist for the National Arts Centre of Canada, and this is video 3 in my 4-part video series on invoking the imagination through the arts for students of all ages. In today's video, I'm going to be inviting my cross-cultural partner, Walter McDonald Whitebear, to talk about the work that we've done together over the last 6.5 years with the Music Alive program for the National Arts Centre, where we've definitely invoked the imagination of the students who we've encountered, and we've really supported them to discover their individual artistic voice. I think in this time of truth and reconciliation, walking in with my Indigenous teaching partner really sets a statement of how we want to move forward into this world with people who come from quite varied backgrounds, walking into a situation where we can really encourage students to find themselves and their voice through the arts. I hope you enjoy this video. Hello, Walter.
Good morning, everyone. So my full name is Walter McDonald Whitebear. I come from Moose Factory, Ontario, and I've been with the National Arts Centre coming up to the 7-year mark. And I've had the great pleasure working with Sam, and we've gone all across Alberta and working with different communities and schools. And it's been a very interesting journey.
So, Walter, this video series is about invoking the imagination. And it's that moment when we take what we're really passionate about and what we really love, and we feel that spark go over to the students or the people that we're working with. Can you name one moment that we've had in our 7 years together where you've really felt that that happened?
Gee, like, it's happened so many times. I can't even think, you know, the first thing that pops in my head, I don't even know if I want to talk about that, but that unfortunate situation. One of my favorite moments was going into that classroom and just creating music on the spot with those kids, and how much they, how it made them alive in such a dark, you know, there's such a dark thing going on in that community.
So to give some context to that, what happened, Walter and I went into a community and there had been a death by suicide the day before we had shown up. And we've been working together, I guess, 3 or 4 years at that time. Hey, Walter, we knew each other pretty well.
Yeah.
And so Walter just looked at me and he said, this whole day is about the kids. This whole day is going to be about the drum. And whenever I'm playing, you're going to do the drum. Whenever you're playing, I'm going to play the drum. And we're just going to make music with these kids. And, you know, Walter, I would say that was a day where the spark that is us became the spark that was them. And how it all kind of culminated was at the end of the day, we ended up performing for kindergarten all the way to grade 12. And there were, oh, I would say, how many kids? 14 kids that lined up to want to play the drum at the end?
Yeah, at least, yeah. Yeah, so I think that was one of my favorite highlights, and just how beautiful they sang, and the different melodies that they came up with, like, on the fly. And I was surprised because, you know, usually Native kids can be very shy, but I think under those circumstances, you know, as bleak as it would, might have given them some courage or some reason to sing.
Yeah, I think you're right. Another moment where I think we've really evoked the imagination is whenever we've gone in with poetry and we've asked the students to write poetry and then create music that goes with it using different guitar patterns. Can you speak a little bit about what that process is like and how you kind of come up with the music that you're going to share with the students, and then how they kind of come up with what they're going to sing over your music?
Right. Well, you know, we've drawn upon like some different inspirations, like that beautiful poem by Chief Seattle, you know, my heart soars, and, you know, we get the kids to think about those sort of thing. And then I really pick like 3 really popular progressions, like, you know, that have been played over like 1,000 times within pop culture, within country, you know, rock and roll and blues. And so there's a foundation there already. And once we get the kids, you know, one of my favorite times is when we got them in a meditative state and got them thinking about the stars and the planet and, you know, their space in it. I was just really shocked about like some of the beautiful poetry that they came up, and sometimes not even necessarily singing over the music, but reciting poetry over it as well is very interesting.
And pretty profound for those students, because a lot of them might not have had an opportunity to speak or perform that way. And they all kind of rise to the occasion because it's their words.
Yes. Yes, I think so.
Yeah.
And it's a demo, you know, we also like, everyone gets a chance. And I think that's something kids really, really gravitate to, is when they get a chance to share their point of view or their opinion. And so there's that element of being inclusive as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And giving everybody a chance. And I think you and I walk into every situation thinking there's going to be success. So failure is not an option. There is going to be success, and there always is. I think that's that optimism that we kind of walk in with. You know, a lot of people have said that you and I walking into a school together is reconciliation through music. To you, what does that mean?
I just think it's like part of like the hidden curriculum. Like, we don't necessarily introduce ourselves as a TRC reconciliation, just the fact that we're working together. And, you know, to be honest, a lot of these smaller communities, there's still quite a big racial divide. Like, the further you get away from the cities and into the northern parts of Alberta, and that's just life. You know, we as a team going in together sends a very positive message to the youth and the staff.
Yeah, I agree. And working together with you as a team has been a real joy in my career. It's been something that I look forward to. And it's been something when the pandemic first hit that I missed desperately. And yet we somehow have found a way to virtually go back into schools and still invoke the imagination of the students we're working with. Can you talk a little bit about how we're doing that virtually with the students, that the 800 students from kindergarten to grade five that we're working with right now?
Well, it was a lot of big wrestling with technology. It took me at least a good 2 weeks to find an appropriate way to express the music through, you know, this virtual platform. And once you got that figured out, even if you use a different web browser, can manipulate the sound. So that there was a lot of challenges, but I think by and large, most of the students are really enjoying themselves. And I think that enthusiasm comes across when they're singing or dancing to the music we're creating.
And I've been really impressed with the music that they've shared with us, that they've been creating, and the soundscapes they're creating, and the stories that they've decided to create. They were quite inspired by the lessons that you taught them around turtle, bear, beaver, and eagle the very first day. And it's really come out in their story writing. And I think that's invoked their imagination. I think that's going to take us to a really interesting place in the next couple of weeks as we expand on this project.
I agree. And I think the opportunity to, like, you know, we're collecting their voices singly, like on recording devices. And I think once we put that all together, I think people are going to be very surprised at the final product.
And touched, because it's kind of encapsulating this time in history for them and giving them something to look forward to. Walter, thank you so much for doing this with me today. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome.
In my next video, I will be talking about a project where we partnered older people in our community with high school students so they could tell their stories through music. In this particular project, we really did invoke the imagination when we invited older people to tell the stories of the younger people and the younger people to tell the stories of the older people. Thank you so much for watching my video series. I would love to invite you to put any comments or questions or feedback in our comment section, because we'd love to hear from you.